I think that everybody understands that Europe is in a critical crossroads, so the discussion was very interesting about the future of Europe. And of course it was an interesting discussion because Greece is a case study for Europe after 8 consecutive years of failed reforms and failed programs, we managed finally to find the right way. And we managed to have a clean exit from the memoranda by deepening reforms that are necessary for Greek economy, when at the same time we managed to protect the most vulnerable people. So the discussion was interesting. I think that at that moment that Europe is struggling to cope with multiple challenges, dialogue is necessary between us. Challenges that have to do with the management of the adverse consequences of the economic crisis within our societies, such as the increase in inequalities and poverty, but also among the member states, such as unprecedented socio-economic divergence. These challenges have to do with the management of the refugee and migration crisis, which not only divides Europe, but more than that, threatens its cohesion as various member states revert to national solutions. So I think, I believe that it was very useful to exchange views this morning, and it was also useful to make clear how necessary it is for Europe to change page. Mr. President before mentioned the necessity to change Europe, but not to kill Europe. This was something that I also mentioned before, that somebody in this plenary, when I was here for the first time 3 years ago, they were threatened by me because they believed that my willingness to change Europe was dangerous for the existing Europe. But the truth is that the real threat for Europe is the forces that want to kill Europe and not the forces that want to change Europe. So I think that our political duty today is to replace today's Europe of fear with a Europe of hope, and to forge a new social contract which would reconnect Europe with its founding principles and values, democratize the Eurozone, and ensure decent living for its citizens. We need to make the European project a project of our people. At the same time, we have to face efficiently the refugee and migration flows. This is a very important challenge, and I fully agree with you that it is necessary to work together in order to reform the Dublin Treaty. I believe that beyond the difficulties, we have already achieved to survive our common home, Europe and European Union, from the financial crisis. And beyond the huge difficulties that we're facing ahead, I believe that it is possible, but also necessary, to work for a Europe that will be Europe for its people, and a Europe that will underline once again the foundation values and principle of solidarity, social cohesion, democracy and cooperation. So with these thoughts, I believe that today was a very interesting and constructive debate, and I want to thank very much once again Mr. President because he gave me this opportunity.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Tsipras, do you want to change the EU position on Brexit to help the UK or stick with what you've got?
You are from UK. That's why the only critical question for you is Brexit, but it's not only Brexit our problem, you know. I think that we're working hard closely and together in order to find the better solution for the European citizens, but also for the UK citizens. I'm confident that at the end of the day we will find a constructive way to do that. Thank you.
Thank you.